Hi, welcome to Unit 25. This time we're going to focus on capital budgeting, but we're going to pay particular attention to this net present value. We're going to focus on three areas. We're going to do a bit of an introduction. We're going to lay the groundwork, the fundamentals for our capital budgeting. And from there, we'll look at our payback method, and then we'll round things off with a net present value method. Okay, let's get the ball rolling. Now, with that capital budgeting, let's discuss why we use capital budgeting. Well, organizations will employ this for many different reasons, but particularly it's based on a course of action. Now, we can consider that a manufacturing plant needs to make some type of decision regarding whether or not to buy or lease equipment, for example. It could also be the selection process between option A or option B, again, with an alternative different equipment or foreign brand equipment, for example. Other cases could be about expansion or a strategy that the company may want to take for the future. So those are the decision-based sides that capital budgeting tries to encapsulate. Now, if we develop this idea a little bit further, we could consider then our capital budgeting looks at doing two things. It works to screen ideas, screen projects, so we can either accept or reject those proposals. The second point is about the idea of preferences. So an organization, a manufacturer will have different options, different courses of action, but by selecting a particular preference, it knows what direction to take that company in. Now, the second point we're going to discuss throughout our unit for today is about our payback period. Now, the payback period, this is quite simple. The calculation for this, you may have already calculated or you may have already been exposed to this back in your undergraduate days. So this payback period, this relates to the investment over the annual cash inflow. So guys, please read through the material carefully and I'll see you later on.